This is the hidden story of the American Army's attacks on South Korean refugees during the Korean War in 1950. No actual archive exists of these precise incidents, but all the archive images in this film used to illustrate the Korean War were taken during the Korean War, almost all of them filmed by US Forces cameramen.
Advanced Headquarters, 5th Air Force, 25 July 1950. The Army has requested that we strafe all civilian parties that are approaching our positions. To date, we have complied with the Army request. Eighth Army Headquarters, secret, 3 January 1951. You have complete authority in your zone to stop all civilian traffic. Responsibility to place fire on them to include bombing rests with you. Headquarters 25th Infantry Division, 26 July 1950. General Keane directed that all civilians moving around in the combat zone will be considered as unfriendly and shot.
Kids, there was kids out there. It didn't matter what it was. 8 to 80, blind, crippled, or crazy, they shot him. It just seemed like all Koreans were the enemy.
We were just shooting openly. We didn't aim at somebody. Just pointing our rifles and shooting. And in that 10 minutes that it went on, that was a nightmare in itself. Yeah, the guilt's still with me. I can't get rid of the guilt. I can't find peace of mind. Absolution, it's not there.
I remember seeing this woman on her hands and knees. She was crawling. You could just see the bullets bouncing, tracer bullets bouncing around her. She kept crawling. Finally, I guess, you know, she was just hit, and that was it. And she just stopped, just like that, you know. Just like she was hanging on the side of this hill with her fingers.
In the village of Kokan-ri, near the south coast of Korea, the Lee family gather to honor their war dead. This ancient Confucian custom requires living descendants to pay homage to their ancestors. On August the 10th, 1950, 6 weeks into the Korean War, several hundred members of the Lee family took refuge in their family shrine. 24 hours later, 82 of them were dead, including 29 children under the age of 10. The irony is that they were all killed by troops sent to protect them from the North Korean invasion, American troops. The South Korean Defense Ministry has registered 61 separate incidents of alleged U.S. attacks on civilians. Last year, the U.S. government finally acknowledged one of them. Tokyo was a dream posting for any young GI in the spring of 1950, with its shattered economy and thriving black market. You could buy a carton of cigarettes at the PX for a dollar and sell it on the street for 10. And $10 would buy you a Japanese wife for a month. Life was easy. There was guard duty and marching on parade, but you never expected to fight.
I remember waiting for a streetcar to take me into downtown Tokyo, and I said to myself at that point, when you look back on this time, you're going to remember it as a really good time, because it really is the best time of your life.
Most GIs only had 2 weeks of combat training in the summer. The North Korean invasion of the South on June the 25th changed all of that.
Some guys were buying knives down in Japan. They were sharpening them up, putting in their boots, and, you know, like it was going to really be like being in a movie or something, so to speak.
We were only told we're moving to Korea. The Koreans crossed the 38th parallel, which nobody knew where it was. Nobody cared. To us, we thought it was just an uprising, something that would be over in no time.
American soldiers from Japan were rushed to the deteriorating front line. In their very first contact with the North Koreans, they were outmaneuvered and soundly defeated. Retreat was the only option.
North Korean forces have driven 60 miles south of Seoul to a point only 15 miles from Daejeon. Here, United States troops, backed by powerful air and artillery concentrations, have temporarily halted the communist tank drive, but no solid defense line has been formed.
It was time to bring in the cavalry. The 7th Cavalry Regiment, General George Custer's old unit, landed in Pahang on July the 22nd.
I remember seeing a large banner, the white banner that stretched across the street there. It said, "Welcome Americans, run commies, run." And all the South Koreans alongside the road, they were waving and cheering us on. Made us feel real good. We thought when we'd show up, you know, it'd be all over with, probably in a short time. But we had no, absolutely no idea of what we were walking into. And I mean, we walked into it.
Things began to go wrong immediately. Within 2 days in Korea, the 7th Cavalry had shot several of their own men. On the next night, July the 25th, elements were positioned on a hillside a few miles behind the front line. Rumors went around that the North Koreans had made a breakthrough, causing mass panic.